ready to match the stars. Bert Convy, Brett Somers, Nipsey Russell, Marianne Mobley, Richard Dawson, and Ann Elder. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 73. And here's the host of Match Game 73, Gene Rayburn.
Hello there. Thank you, Johnny Olson. I think you're ready. I think you're ready to participate in whatever you're going to participate in here. Are you ready?
Yeah,
you look just dandy. You're not ready?
No, I said we can't wait.
Oh, good. All right. Well, let's begin by saying hello to our two players here, Robert Spencer Jr. and Kathy Stone. All right, Kathy. Good. Kathy is our current champ. She's won one game as a total of $350 to her credit. And she is being challenged now by Robert Spencer Jr. I think you ought to repeat this little story you told us yesterday about yourself, because some people, or whenever it was we were together last time, might not have heard it. So.
Oh, I just said that I have just graduated from a television and radio school here in Hollywood, and I hope to eventually become a host of a game show, and I hope I be as well and do as good a job as you do of the Match Game 73.
Right, thank you very much, Robert. Good luck to you.
Thank you.
We'll start this game right after we finish this. We are ready to start a brand new game. Robert Spencer Jr., the challenger makes a selection, so would you do that, please?
I'll select A.
He selects A, it is. Everyone plays. The president said,
ha ha. Prove it.
We don't know what he said.
We
don't know what the president said. Let me tell you what. Oh, you don't have to know. No. Listen to the president said, let me make one thing perfectly clear.
Yeah?
At this year's White House masquerade party, I don't want anybody dressed up as. Blank.
Oh!
Wait a minute.
This year's.
Could you hear all of that?
No, I didn't.
You didn't. Shall I repeat it for your benefit?
Please do.
The president said, let me make one thing perfectly clear. At this year's White House masquerade party, I don't want anybody dressed up as blank.
I can't seem to get it.
It's only three letters.
No, it isn't. It's four.
No, it's eight.
Are you thinking about this, Robert Spencer? Okay, he's thinking about it. He's got his answer probably already. I don't know what you're holding you up over there. All right, we're all set now. Robert, give us your response to this. At this year's White House masquerade party, I don't want anybody dressed up as...
jackasses.
For the Democratic Party, yeah.
Or donkeys.
Oh, donkeys. Oh, yeah, I see. Okay. All right. We'll accept donkey, Robert. It's all right with you. Okay. He says donkey.
Donkeys
is a symbol of the Democratic Party.
It's a very good answer, however. I said he didn't want anybody dressed up as a bug.
As a bug. No bug. Okay, there's one answer and no match. Brett, what do you say?
Well, we all know what a politician is, but he didn't want anyone dressed as a statesman.
As a statesman. President
don't
said,
you
let me
get
make
it?
One thing perfectly clear. Yeah, I get it. I don't want
you,
it.
You got it. You got it, thanks.
At this year's White House masquerade party, what's I don't want name? Anybody dressed up as.
Well, during the Watergate proceedings, I learned that SOB meant Senate Office Building, so I put a senator.
A senator. All right. Robert's looking for the answer, donkey. What do you say, Marianne?
Well, I muddied the water a little further, and I said Sam Irvin.
Sam Irvin. Okay. Now, Mr. Dawson, what do you think about this whole proceeding?
Well, darling, where I come from, the twilight bird has lights in front and a bug near his...
I see. Okay, so he's a bug. Donkey is Robert's answer, and Ann.
In hindsight and in point of time, I said Senator Irvin.
Senator Irvin. Okay, so there's no match there. Let us move to Kathy Stone's assignment, and this is it, Kathy. Everyone participates once again. Sarah said, just because Marvin is blank, it doesn't mean he's not a nice person.
Just because Sarah Marvin said. Is what?
Sarah said, Just because Marvin is blank, it doesn't mean he's not a nice person.
Oh, okay.
Got the idea.
Yeah, I've got a lot of ideas.
Well,
I don't know what to do with them.
Choose one. Kathy will think of an answer now that will attempt to match all six celebrities.
Oh, dear.
Sarah said that. Just because Marvin is blank, it doesn't mean he's not a nice person.
Well,
I don't understand what's so mystifying about that, do you? Nipsey's ready. The bottom tier is ready. Upper tier.
Oh, it's the first time they beat us this week, the little devils. Come along.
Well, I'm trying.
Now he's ready. So we'll come over here to Kathy Stone and see how she responds. Sarah said just because Marvin is blank, it doesn't mean he's not a nice person.
Just because Marvin is ugly.
Ugly.
Yeah. Oh.
Doesn't mean he's not a nice person. He's beautiful
That's
inside.
That's a beautiful thought.
It is a lovely thought. Let's see if
I take
scores
offense to that. I'm
not
married
true,
to Jack Klugman.
He's a nice person.
And the middle syllable of that name
we'll
is.
Get up to Bert Convy here.
Yes. Well, ugly is a very lovely thought. That's true. I said just because he's a pervert, he's a nice person. I couldn't think of any villains, you know.
Okay.
You Brett, did all right.
I never met a pervert Brett? I didn't like. I don't know.
What? What does that mean?
I don't. Will Rogers said that.
Shall we move on over here?
Well, I just thought the nicest person I ever knew was my daddy, and he was a drunk.
He was a drunk.
Wrong with that.
Because he's a drunk. That's pretty good.
All right. Nipsey?
Well, I know Sarah, and I know Marvin, and Marvin is stupid.
He is stupid. Okay, just because he's stupid is not nice, doesn't mean he's not a nice person. What did you say, Marianne?
Listen, Brett's right. He was drunk.
Drunk. Okay, that seems to be the answer here.
I happen to know that Marvin and Sarah had been necking, and then...
Then he got drunk?
She sort of straightened herself up, came in and said to her mom, just because Marvin's aroused, it doesn't mean...
a nice person.
He goes off.
Okay, Ann.
Well, would you like to, also said
yeah, would you like to carry on, Ann?
I would love to carry on. With whom?
No. Oh, Marvin. Marvin. Marvin's ready.
I know that Marvin. Right. Unfortunately, the Marvin I know was a sissy.
Okay. So there was no match there. We'll go to round two and ask Robert to make a selection.
Yes, I'll stick with A.
He wants A once again. You didn't match anyone in the first time. That means everyone plays now.
So far, we've been brilliant.
Yes. Frank said, I've really got my wife trained. I ring a bell and she blanks.
I don't think that's...
Frank said, I've really got my wife trained. I ring a bell and she blanks. Richard had a thought immediately.
I'm the best.
You're the best, Richard.
Oh, I can't say that. Thank you. I've been first.
Yes.
All right, just put it right in the slot there. As long as you're finished with it, do not tarry.
Third card is going to be in his mouth.
Third card.
He has a little trouble.
Okay. Now, Robert, what do you say? Frank said, I've really got my wife trained. I ring a bell and she blanks.
Jumps.
She jumps. He says, I ring a bell and she jumps. What do you say, Bert?
I said, he rings a bell and she jumps out of her clothes. I said, disrobes.
Disrobes. Okay, Brett.
Well, you've seen Jack and me together on this show.
Yes, we have.
Jumps.
Jumps.
Why did I say what I said?
All right, there's one match.
I was thinking about Pavlova's dog. She eats the Avon lady.
She eats. Ring a bell and she eats the Avon lady.
Oh, that's terrible.
Well... So, let's come down here. Pull yourself together. Up you go here. Well, you pick this card up and you hold it up and you say the answer at the same time. I'll say it for you.
Hey, stop giggling.
She says, brings my slippers. Okay, I'll put the thing in the slot.
And let's put her in the slot.
Put your head back down again. All right, sir, would you give us your answer? Just keep
he
it
rings,
down there.
Does he blow a whistle or ring a bell?
He rings a bell.
And she comes to it.
Okay.
And after that, she attacks me.
Well, You scored once with that. Folks, just here in the nick of time, we have a commercial message for you. All right, in the first half of round two, our final round here, Robert Spencer scored once. We are now going to the second half. Kathy, you need one match to tie. Two will win the game. And everyone plays.
Everyone plays.
Listen to this, folks.
We're going to do that.
All of Sally's muscles are in her blank. All of Sally's muscles are in her blank.
All of Sally's.
I can hardly wait for this one.
I know what I'm thinking.
Don't say it yet. Until they've finished writing. Rhett and Nipsey are not finished. And you can't think, right? Okay. Everybody ready over there. Now, Kathy, think carefully before you give your answer. Remember, one to tie, two to win. All of Sally's muscles are in her blank.
Sally does a lot of horseback riding and other events, too. And all of Sally's muscles are in her legs.
All of Sally's muscles are in her legs. She said legs.
We heard
what
her
do you
say,
say?
Legs.
Bert.
I said all her muscles are in her head.
Her head.
Yes.
That's a good answer. What do you think of that? Okay, Brett, what do you say?
I don't want to hear any cheap talk about this not matching. Calves, which is
calves.
In your legs.
Well, I don't know. I've got to make an appeal from the judge.
Yes,
yeah.
That is a match?
I knew it.
Okay. All right, the score is now tied. If you match Nipsey, you'll win another game. Go, Nipsey. She's looking.
I match Bert.
You match Bert.
And I win the game, right?
No, you don't win anything.
Oh, I don't win.
You guys can go out together later if you'd like to. What do I care? Mary Ann.
And I match Nipsey and Bert.
We'll all go together.
Right.
We're split
right.
Anyway.
Let's yes. See now. If you match Richard Dawson, you could win the game.
Sally had to be an English girl.
Really?
And they were in her London derriere.
In her derriere.
You had to be there, I guess.
Yes, I suppose so. All right, Ann, last chance. Here we go.
How about fourth for bridge with the other members?
Oh, hey. All right. Head it is. We've got a tie here. We've got to go to a tiebreaker. To do that, we'll wipe the board clean and push the button, and the tiebreaker will appear. One question. The one who scored the most matches will be the winner. Challenger always goes and make a selection.
There. I'll stay with A.
You've got to stay with A. Right. Okay, Robert, here it is. This is his tiebreaker. Everyone plays.
Does Robert still want to be a host of a game show?
Not anymore.
Henry the traveling salesman said, hello, room service? Send up a blank, quick. Henry the traveling salesman said, hello, room service? Send up a blank, quick.
I love the way you do it. I mean, say the line.
Of course. See you later.
That's what he told me.
Everyone plays on this. Already down here? Marianne, are you still thinking? What are you doing?
Oh, she was blowing in my ear. It's my
oh,
ear.
Oh, all right.
She's blown in everybody's ear today here, or okay. Here today.
All right, they're all finished.
That's
all right, Robert Spencer Jr., give us your answer. Henry, the traveling salesman, said, hello, room service, send up a blank, quick.
Well, if I was Henry, I would want a woman.
A woman?
Yeah.
Okay, he says.
Very understanding.
He says, I want a woman. Bert, what do you say?
I said, send up a broad. Bert.
Oh, okay. Light lights up, so there's a match. Brett?
I said, chick.
A chick.
And. I put the E-N underneath there in case you didn't. So does that count?
Well, now, I don't know. She's got chicken here.
Chick.
Chick in big, bold letters and E-N in fine print.
Because I'm a girl, and I thought, well, they'll only get hateful.
Oh, I see. So chick is your answer.
Yes.
All right. Well, that's a match. All right. Nipsey, what do you say?
Well, Henry was a young traveling salesman. I said, send up a girl.
Send up a girl. Okay. All right, Marianne.
My mother is going to be thrilled with my terminology, but I said abroad.
Abroad. Mom, your little girl said that. Marianne, former Miss America, said that abroad.
Henry all right, actually let's picked up the telephone, said, room service, send me a room. Well, it's cleaner than broad, isn't it?
That's not a male chauvinist pig answer.
I wouldn't give one.
All right.
Exit is over
Let's
there.
Let's find out what Ann Elder says.
You and I went to the same comedy school, right, didn't we? Send up our room, please.
Send up a room.
We have two rooms.
Okay, so you scored four times with
both
that.
Of you, the exit
now you must match four celebrities, Kathy. Five, however, could win the game for you. All right, everyone ready?
We're ready.
Here yes. we go. Everyone plays.
Sure.
This is her half of it.
Where did I get my leg up here?
She's got a leg in his pocket.
Can we have a little dignity?
Yes, I'm terribly sorry, Doc.
It's a serious show.
So far, yes.
Well, we didn't intend it. It just turned it out.
You can always tell a Texan by the way he blinks. You can always tell a Texan by the way he blinks.
You can always tell a Texan, but you can't tell him much.
We just lost Dallas.
If there'd been a back door to the Alamo, San Antonio would be in Mexico.
And Mexico.
All right, now they're all finished, Kathy. You think carefully before you give an answer. What answer you think will match the celebrities on this? You can always tell a Texan by the way he blanks.
By the way he walks?
By the way he walks. All right. Let's find out what answers we get.
No, no, dear, we said Texan.
Oh, Texan. The strange Texan. Listen.
A silly Texan?
Bert, he's silly. You can always tell a Texan by the way he...
Mine rhymes. I can't read it. Oh, yes. By the way, he talks, I
He
say.
Talks.
Yes, sir.
Here's his walks. All right, Brett.
Well, my dearest friend is... Her name is Angelique, and she comes from Texas, and she talks real funny.
That's it. All right, talk. Now, you got to match the remaining celebrities to stay in the game. Nipsey.
Well, I like them barbecues. It's the way we talk now.
Oh, we've got a new winner, Robert Spencer. Congratulations to you. Come on, Bob. Here we go. Stand right there, everyone, please. You got the $100. We congratulate you. And we're going to say goodbye to Kathy Stone. She's going to leave with $350. Together with our thanks for being on Match Game 73, Kathy Stone. All right. We'll get back to this fellow here right after we pass along these messages. This fellow's won his first game, and I guess he's excited about that, aren't you?
Yes, I am. My anti-freshman just stopped working.
All right. Stand over there, and we'll come back. No, I'm only kidding. You've got $100. You're going to go with the big money now here in the Super Match, Robert. And we polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Blank chips. The answer they gave most often is worth $500 if you can match it. The second most frequent response, $250, and the third, $100. Okay, you're allowed a little help from three celebrities to suggest answers one at a time, if you would, please.
Marianne.
There are a couple good ones, but potato chips.
She says potato chips. All right, there's one answer for you.
Nipsey.
Nipsey.
Well, this isn't actually our national game, but I said poker chips.
Poker chips. All right, there's two for you.
Richard Dawson.
Well, my national game, fish and chips.
Yeah. Yes.
Fish and chips. All right.
And no salt or vinegar, please.
There. Poker chips, potato chips, and fish and chips are the three you have been given. You may choose one of those or give us one of your own.
I'll go with potato chips.
Yeah. You'll go with the potato chips. Yeah. Okay, he says potato chips. That's the answer he's looking for. Let's all together take a look at that $100 response. Mr. Chips.
Goodbye, Mr. Chips.
So long, loser. So long, Mr. Chips. All right, that's not it. We're still looking for potato chips. We are now going to show you the $250 response.
There,
poker chips.
Was right there.
Attaboy, Nipsey, that was your answer, but it's a loser. Here we go. Third and last chance for potato chips. Here is the $500 response.
Yes, sir.
So, Robert, you win the $500. That means you're up to $600 altogether now. And that means also you're going to play for 10 times that amount, or $5,000. Now, to collect that, you got to match one celebrity on a head-to-head basis. and your answers must be exact. So turn around and choose a celebrity.
I'll go with Marianne again.
Okay, Marianne, you get ready to write. Robert, you face me. Here is the $5,000 question.
Listen, opposites attract.
Lucky blank. Marianne will write her answer to that. Lucky blank. Can't take too much time, Marianne.
Oh, just a minute.
Lucky blank.
Okay. Responsibility.
It's a lot of responsibility when $5,000 is at stake. All right, tell us how you fill in that blank. Lucky.
I'll say lucky number.
Lucky number. Marianne, for $5,000, may we see your answer?
Lucky day.
Lucky day. All right. They're both good answers. You're up to $600, and we'll tell you what's going to happen next right after we have this message for you. Robert Spencer will be back tomorrow to meet a new player, and we'll start a brand new game. And we hope you'll join us next time, too. Will you do that,
yes,
folks?
Yes, well, you're coming apart.
That's very kind of you. Thank you. This is Gene Rayburn saying so long for Match Game 73. Bye.
Today's consolation prizes are Miro electronic housewares, including the couple-minute percolator and the Miromatic Manhattan speed cooker, the modern way to prepare meals in minutes instead of hours. And Charm Glowette, the completely portable gas grill that goes anywhere. Instant flame without starter fluids or charcoal. Charm Glow products of Antioch, Illinois. And from the Chapstick people, Chap-Ans lotion. Extra rich and non-greasy. With Chap-Ans lotion, your whole body can have softer feeling, smoother looking skin. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 73. A Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. To match the stars, Bill Cullen, Brett Somers, Jack Klugman, Cass Elliot, Richard Dawson, and Loretta Switz as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 73. And now here's the host of Match Game 73, Gene Rayburn.
He'd do anything not to get a laugh. But he did it. Nice to have you with us here today. And thank you for joining us at home, wherever you are in America. And thank you for joining us because you're a splendid, talented bunch of people. Aren't you?
Thanks.
Yes.
Yeah.
For you to say.
Yes. Are you all ready?
No. Yes.
Good. Would you like to greet our two players, Antoinette Osborne and Bill Goldstein?
No, thanks.
No?
I thought so.
Yeah. Bill is the current champ. He's won $5,600, and he did that in only one game. And last time we were together, he was being challenged by Antoinette. We started that game, got halfway through round one. Antoinette scored one match. We were about to get to his question when time expired, and we're going to pick up there today, right after this message. So don't you go away. Now, if you're all set here, we'll push the button and reveal Bill Goldstein's question. Listen carefully, Bill. Everybody plays.
Except
me.
No, everybody plays.
Well, I didn't say they didn't. I just said except.
Everybody plays.
I had that word left over from yesterday.
Okay. All right. I came here to play.
That's right.
That's right.
And you're going to play.
Okay.
You're going to get ready to...
I'm ready. This is it.
Batman said to Robin, please don't ever tell anyone I wear blank. Batman said to Robin, please don't tell anyone ever that I wear blank.
Now, Batman said that to Robin.
Batman said that to Robin.
He's the older one. He's not the kid, right?
Right. Yes, Robin is the kid.
My God. Right along.
Presto.
Oh. Right. Now.
Did you hear the question loud and clear? Batman said to Robin, please don't ever tell anyone I wear. Okay, all set over there? So we'll get a response now from Bill Goldstein. Please don't tell anyone I wear...
pantyhose.
Pantyhose, he said.
Pantyhose.
Pantyhose. That's what he said, pantyhose, you know.
What's wrong with that?
You always thought it was that blue suit. It's pantyhose, really.
They're very good.
Yeah, that's...
I'm a garter belt man myself.
Yes.
So I wrote longies, I'm sorry. But that's sort of like pantyhose.
Longies, no, we can't match that because longies have no feet in them and pantyhose do. What do you say, Brett?
Well, one of the reasons I was so curious about whether it was the younger one or the older one, you noticed I asked that question earlier on, because he wore lace underwear.
Oh. Lace underwear.
Yes, there's nothing wrong with lace underwear, dear, as long as you stay out of Portland, Maine. Right?
Yes.
Right. There's nothing wrong with it. She bought me six lovely pairs of
lace panties. So that's the way it is with Batman, eh? What do you say it is with Batman?
I say pantyhose.
Pantyhose gives you a match. You say...
bananas, and you say bananas.
Oh,
no,
tomatoes.
I know that he wore, everyone knew he wore pantyhose. What he was worried about was the fact he wore lipstick.
Lipstick. That was carrying it a bit too far.
I don't think so, but some people do. The commissioner particularly.
Yes, of course.
He had a terrible ego problem, and he didn't want anyone to know that he was getting older, and he had to wear false teeth.
Oh, I see. Okay. So he asked Robin to keep that a secret.
You're going back to
so at the end of round one, one to one is the score, and we go to round two. Antoinette, what is your selection?
B.
B it is for Antoinette. Last time out, you matched Cass Elliott, so you will not participate in this.
Just what if I take a short nap? Thank you.
Take a short nap or count your gold bracelets or do something like that. Myron said, I was at Lawrence Welk's house the other night, and I actually saw bubbles coming out of his blank.
I'm glad I was
Myron said that. I was at Lawrence Welk's house the other night. I actually saw bubbles coming out.
I heard you the first time.
Oh, all right. That's enough already. Jack is ready.
Always first.
Jack is
I'm
first
ready.
One.
He you can't understand his writing.
What
so
do you want, class or
speech?
There we go. Now, Antoinette, how do you respond to this? Myron said, I was at Lawrence Welk's house the other night, and I actually saw bubbles coming out of his...
ears.
Ears. Bubbles coming out of Lawrence Welk's ears. It's a neat trick if you can do it, Bill. Can you do it?
Bubbles had been invited to the party, and she was coming out of the bathroom at the time.
All right.
What does Lawrence Welk play?
The accordion.
Oh, well, coming out of his instrument. I didn't know what he was playing.
Right, accordion, right, okay.
Once he removed the accordion, it came out of his navel.
Out of his navel. No ears yet, Antoinette. Let's see if we get something down here from Richard Dawson.
Oh, I'm sorry, he left.
Did he leave?
Yeah, no, actually, the bubbles came out of his bathroom.
Out of the bathroom.
Oh, well done.
One
well
bubble
done.
I see, okay.
No, they came out of his swimming pool.
Swimming pool, but no ears for poor Antoinette. Now let's see what we've got here for Bill Goldstein. You matched Cass last time, so again, you will not participate. I'm sorry.
You will lay out, Cass.
So am I.
She's the best.
You all remember Chester from Gunsmoke?
Oh,
uh-huh.
Yeah.
Remember?
Want to see me do it?
He said, yeah, would you like
it? No,
yeah.
Not now. No.
Do you do it? No. Well, I'll try and do it. How does he sound?
Mr. Dillon.
Well, Mr. Dillon, the reason I
That's
limp...
Good, Gene. That's
what are we auditioning here for Major Bones? What's
quiet.
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 I got a job. What do you want to put? You want to put Frank Gorsham out of work?
Shoot it, thing here.
You were saying.
It's my show, and I'm going to do it if I want to do it.
Okay.
Boy. He's the host.
Well, Mr. Dillon, the reason I went.
Get back up there, Jack.
Get your stick, Jane.
Yeah, well, Mr. Dillon, the reason I left is because I got my foot stuck in a blank. That's all.
What?
He said, well, Mr. Dillon, the reason I limp is because I got my foot stuck in a blank. That's not Chester.
Because I got my foot stuck in a blank.
That's
in a blank. You didn't write. Okay.
Stuck in a... I got my foot.
All you need is one to win the game.
I got my foot stuck in a blank.
Brett is not finished
oh,
yet.
Okay. What is that thing?
As far as the business is concerned.
Right.
What are those things? Oh, like they?
Okay, now she's ready. Ready? Not ready.
Yes, now I'm ready.
Now ready.
I'm ready's brother.
Coming ready now.
Okay, Bill. Well, Mr. Dillon, the reason I limp is because I got my foot stuck in a...
door.
In a door. Rotten answer, huh? Is that what you're telling him? Okay, that's what they're telling him.
Huh? He's already depressed.
No, I won't do Chester again. Yeah, give us your answer.
I won't do Paul Lynde.
No, I won't do Paul Lynde either. Give us your answer.
Speaking from experience, Gene, it'll do it when you get stuck in a cuspidor.
In a cuspidor, yeah. All right, one door will win the game for him, Brett.
Actually, this isn't my answer, but I couldn't think of what my answer was. Yeah. So I put sawhorse, but you know what I meant. But it didn't match his anyway.
Doesn't match his anyway.
Thank you. Can't worry about
that's
it.
Enough. Okay.
It happened when a guy turned to him and said, are you Chester from Gunsmoke? And he got foot caught in the urine.
Okay. All right. Aren't you glad you're not playing? Yeah, Richard, what do you say? That's enough of that, then.
Yeah, I beg your pardon. What was the question?
The question was...
the question you asked me.
May I have your answer, please?
The answer is no. Got his foot caught in a bucket.
In a bucket. Last chance here to win with a door. Let's see if we get it from Loretta Smith.
All outdoors and everything, it was outside in a gopher hole.
A gopher hole.
What do you know about gopher holes?
So, at the end of round two, it's tied up 1-1, and we'll tell you what happens in that circumstance right after we tell you about this. Now, when we get a tie, we wipe the slate clean, and we push the button. We go to a tiebreaker. One question, the one who has scored the most matches will be the winner. All right, challenger, make your selection.
B.
Here it is. For Antoinette, everyone plays. Steve was surprised when Stella got blank sooner than he expected.
Steve was surprised when Stella got what, dear?
Blank.
Sooner than he expected.
Did you hear that, Antoinette? Steve was surprised when Stella got blank sooner than he expected. All right, folks, they're all set. So now we'll call on Antoinette. What do you say when Stella got blank sooner than he expected?
Pregnant.
I guess the audience is with you on that. Let's find out if the celebrities are with you on that. Are you with her on that, Bill? Pregnant is her answer.
I am with her every inch of the way. You asked me.
Yes, all right. Brett, what do you say?
Well, Stella was married to Arthur, and Stephen and Arthur were best friends, and he was surprised that he...
Good. That's another match for you, Antoinette and Jack.
He sure was surprised since he claimed he never put a finger on it.
Right. Yeah. All right, that's not... would not be the way to do it, but Jess, we'll go on to your answer.
When Stella got home sooner than he...
Yourself.
Bill really
she means it, I know her. Yeah, that's why I was surprised, because it was the other lady that got preggy when she got home.
All right, now, Sneeko. Let's see what you have, Loretta.
Yes, no, you're all wrong.
All wrong.
No, she got drunk and then she got preggy.
Than expected, really.
And then they went home. See, she didn't...
All right.
no need
so
to draw on your own personal
three.
Experience.
And we'll see how Bill does with this. Listen carefully, Bill. You have no score at all there. Only his hairdresser knows for sure that Melvin is blank. Only his hairdresser knows for sure that Melvin is blank. Everybody plays.
I love you when you smile like that.
All right, Bill Collins, the first one ready, isn't he? Put it in the slot there, and that'll indicate that you are ready.
Bill Collins, show off.
They're already two. Now, Bill Goldstein. Only his hairdresser knows for sure that Melvin is...
bald.
He says bald.
Bald. Tell him he's wrong.
Where's he from? If he says bald.
Bald, as he said. Bald. Bill, what do you say? You say bald?
Did Bill say bald?
No, I don't know. I'm asking Bill if he said bald.
If that Bill said bald, then this Bill, I think I misspelled it, but that's what I said.
Bald is a match. All right. Two to go to tie, three to win, Bill. Here we go, Brett.
Jack Klugman is bald, but what's his name was blonde.
Blonde. Yeah. Okay. Bald is the answer we're looking for,
hateful.
Jack.
Melvin, that was not his name. His name was Jacqueline. He was a girl.
Only said that Melvin is a girl. Okay.
Who else would know?
So you need two more to stay in the game. Let's see what you get from Cass Elliott.
Only his hairdresser knows that he was bald.
Bald. That's one. You got two to get one here. Let's see if you get one from Richard.
See, if he was bald, I don't know why he would go to a hairdresser.
Yes, dear.
Oh, you're very logical.
Should we start this round again? Well, no, don't let me be one to spoil the party. Know that he was gray, spelled with an A.
Gray.
Do you notice the subtlety there, folks?
Yes.
I'm not here to be stared at, you.
All right. Now, you must
I could be walking the line.
Bill, you've got to match Loretta Swit. That beautiful lady who works in that marvelous TV show called MASH.
We know
the game is over.
Yeah.
Go.
You stand the tension. Bald.
Bald. Tie the score. So the tiebreaker ended up in a tie. And we've got to pause here now and pass along these messages. And you come right back and we'll tell you what happens after that. All right, here we go. This tiebreaker ended in a tie. So, Richard Dawson, if you'll say the magic word, well, we'll wipe the slate clean.
Cancel! Oh, I know that's the wrong word. The lights went out. Let's get on with it.
And we push the button and go to another tiebreaker. Antoinette, we ask you to make a selection.
B.
B is what she wants.
Everyone. There's a pacemaker in the house.
The rumor was all over the circus. The fat lady was going to marry the blank. The rumor was all over the circus. The fat lady was going to marry the blank.
Wasn't there a joke about that once?
I don't know. There may have been.
There may have been.
But that, this is neither the time nor the place. Attaboy, Bill. Lower tier is ready, Brett. Now you're ready. Now, Antoinette, the rumor was all over the circus. The fat lady was going to marry the...
skinny man.
The skinny man. All right, Bill, what do you say about this?
Fat
How
lady.
Say you, sir?
And he was never seen again.
The thin man. Okay, we won that. Brett?
Does midget fall into the category of thin?
No.
A lot of fat midgets.
Could be a fat midget, yes. Jack?
Thin man.
Thin man, another match over there. Cass, what did you say?
The thin man.
Thin man, another man. She's up to three. Richard Dawson.
Actually, the fat lady was going to marry William Powell, always known as the thin man. Be that as it may.
What does that have to do with Bill
with
Dana?
Lady Chaplin.
You were Loretta.
Saying, yes, no, I thought everyone knew. It's the snake charmer that she's going to marry.
I've got a carpenter who can cut this off.
She won't tell. Well,
if you were smart, I wouldn't love you.
Snake charmer?
You know, she doesn't speak her lines on MASH. They dub them in.
They dub them in, okay. So you're up to four with that. Now let's go to Bill's end of it.
Excellent.
This is for Bill Goldstein. Now let's see if we can break this tie. It's up to you. Helen said to her husband, I don't care what you say. I think we should have separate blanks. Careful. We like your enthusiasm, but your answers may be rotten. Helen said to her husband, I don't care what you say, I think we should have separate blanks. Now, Bill, we should have separate...
beds.
Beds. You like the audience's answer? All right, let's see if that happens. Bill, what did you say? Beds is his.
They weren't getting along very well at all, but I went along with Helen.
Separate beds, okay. Brett?
When you've been married 17 and a half years to Jack Klugman, honey, it goes a lot further than separate beds. It goes into bedrooms.
Bedrooms? Well, that's there.
You cannot try to get separate countries. I said rooms, too.
Rooms. Okay, you must match the remaining three to stay in the game and achieve a tie. Cass?
Separate checkbooks?
Separate checkbooks. Well, Jeanette is the winner. Congratulations. Come on down. Okay. So, you've gotten $100, and we'll tell you what happens right after we have a word or two with Bill Goldstein. He's going to leave us now, but he's not too unhappy about that. Hope you've enjoyed it here, Bill, have you?
It's been great, really.
Well, it's been great meeting you. You're going to be leaving here richer by $5,600. Goodbye, Bill. Thank you. How do you feel?
I'm happy.
Are you happy about the whole thing?
Yes.
All right, now you know you can win over $5,000 here, so shall we begin it?
Yes.
We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Blank digger. You almost didn't pull it all out, did you, there? Do you want to shove it back in and try it again there? No, it's all right. Blank digger is the thing there. Now, the answer that audience gave most often is worth $500 to you, Antoinette, if you can match it. $250 for the second most frequent response, and $100 for the third most frequent response. Now, you can get a little help from our celebrities here. Which one would you like to start with?
Cass.
Gold digger.
Yay! Gold digger, she said. Okay.
With glee, she says.
With glee, she says. With an armful of gold, I should think you'd say, hold up your gold for the people there. Look at that gold there. Okay.
You're going to get mugged in the parking lot, Cass.
Jack Klugman, what'd you say?
Clam digger.
Clam digger, he says.
Get out of here,
Jack. Boy. What is that? Where do you see it up there?
And Loretta.
Ditch digger.
Ditch digger. So you've got gold digger, clam digger, and ditch digger. Now, Antoinette, you can give us one of those as the answer or choose one of your own. What would you like to do?
Gold digger.
You'd like the gold digger. Okay, that's the answer she's looking for. And that's the answer we're looking for right now. Let's find out where it is. Here is the $100 response. Ditch digger is up there, the one that Loretta gave you. Still looking for gold digger. Here we go with a $250 response. Grave digger is an answer that didn't occur to anyone. Well, it occurred to him over there. Yes, it did. All right. Still looking for gold digger. Let's find out if it's the $500 response.
It is
indeed. Very good, Cass. Okay.
Did you do a lot of this?
Not much.
You picked it. $500, that means, well, we got to go on from there, but at this moment we've got to stop right now and pass along these messages, and we'll come right back to you. Well, when we get back together next time, Antoinette Osborne will have a go at the real big money, and I hope you'll be here. Will you be here?
I sure will.
Splendid.
I'll be anywhere you are, sweetheart.
Gene Rayburn here, inviting you to join us next time for Match Game 73. Thank you and goodbye.
Today's consolation prizes are a Texas Instruments calculator. Adds, subtracts, multiplies, divides in the palm of your hand. Advanced electronic technology at your fingertips from Texas Instruments. And an assortment of Trouble aftershave and cologne gift sets. Trouble has a scratch and sniff spot on the outside so you can smell what's inside. And Honeysuckle White Turkey from Ralston Purina, the premium basted turkey in the red checkerboard package. Honeysuckle Turkey, the Ralston Purina checkerboard. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 73, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. We'll be right back. Sarah Kennedy, Richard Dawson, and Betty White as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 75. And now, here's the star of Match Game 75, Gene Rayburn.
Up, John? Are they ready? You could have a good time tonight because all of these beautiful, gracious, talented, gay
today.
Yeah, today.
We don't know what they're going to do tonight.
Oh, today. Beg your pardon. It's 3 o'clock in some places and 2 o'clock in others.
I have 5 minutes after 8.
Wrong! Are you all ready?
Yeah.
Your watch is always 5 minutes after. Right?
Are you all gay and full of vim, vigor, and vitality?
Well, I'm not gay, I'll tell you that.
I want to see each and every one of you applaud as we welcome Missy Gallant and Margaret Kirkpatrick.
Charles!
Thank you. Now, this lady's the current champ. She's won one game and has $350 to her credit. That's not a large amount, but the day is young. See, I didn't say the night is young. But the night is young, my dear. And she's being challenged by Margaret, who did extremely well with her first round question. Five is most unusual for a first rounder, isn't it? So, you've got your work cut out for you, but you're going to have two shots at least. And we'll see how this game turns out right after we see about this. We are ready to carry on. Middle of round one. Missy, this is your first round question. Listen carefully. The mad scientist crossed a rhinoceros with a chicken.
What a neat trick.
He got a 2-ton chicken that blinks wherever it wants to.
Once more.
All right, Charles. Captain, are you ready? Now hear this.
Now hear this.
The mad scientist crossed a rhinoceros with a chicken. He got a 2-ton chicken that blinks wherever it wants to.
2-ton.
2-ton chicken.
That's a lot of chicken.
All right. He's got it.
Gee. Somebody's having hysterics out there.
I think she's laying
an
egg.
Seizure.
She's cackling enough. Charles.
I'm getting it.
Would the lady continue her whatever she's doing until... Where is she?
One word.
Oh, there. Is that your husband with you? They're all pointing at each other. No one wants to take responsibility. Okay, let's go. Now, are you ready? Okay. The mad scientist crossed a rhinoceros with a chicken. He got a 2-ton chicken that blinks wherever it wants to.
Clucks.
What?
Clucks.
Clucks.
They're awing you. I don't know what that means, but we'll find out now, Bobby.
Find out. Yeah. I thought for sure she was going to say lays eggs wherever she
lays
was.
Lays eggs! Did you think of that, Missy? And you rejected it?
Yes.
Why?
I don't know.
Clucks was such a great answer.
Yeah.
Yes, right.
What'd you say, Brett?
I think clucks is a terrific answer.
It clucks wherever it wants to.
Yes. Because it rhymes with cackles.
Oh, there's a man.
Sorry, God.
Okay, cackles and clucks. Charles?
I still say that answer like an egg.
Okay. All right, Missy, you got one so far. Let's see if you score with the lower panel down here. Sarah, you're up.
Well, I said lays eggs.
Lays eggs, yeah. Wherever it wants to.
Wherever.
Yes, and Richard, what did you say?
Yes, Richard.
About a two-ton chicken.
Pardon?
This two-ton chicken.
Yeah.
Powerful. It blinks wherever it wants to.
Well, that's very interesting. How'd it turn out?
Well, it went into the barnyard and demolished the barn.
I didn't know which was correct English, so I said lays or lies. You would have had a lot of...
That's right. It would have been very good. Betty, what did you say?
Having studied animals as much as I have, that may seem like a strange combination. It is strange, but the courtship is delightful. Yeah. I said lays.
Lays, okay. So at this moment, the score is 5-1. We go to round two, and you have a choice here, Margaret, of A or B.
B, please.
B, and only one person plays. And that person...
Huckleberry Dillinger.
Yes. Captain Charles, are you ready?
I'm ready, sir.
This is for you and you alone.
Have you met Miss Brett, my pretty intended?
Oh,
how are you,
so
honey?
Pleased to meet you all. It's so completely. I've been with Captain Andy for now 25 years.
Yes, you come up north
and
very
he's
often.
He's never laid a hand on me.
And that's where he's going to be. Okay. Jimmy said to Judy, don't look at the card because it's going to distract you. Just look at my eyes. Look at my face. Watch my lips move as I'm speaking.
All right.
He said...
Jimmy to Jenny.
No. Jimmy to Judy. How do I love thee?
Oh, sweet. Did you get my last letter? All right, come on.
Now, wait a minute.
Like it up here. You see how much better it is up here?
I'm acting and you're upstaging me. And you know that's
also
a cardinal sin.
Browning.
How do I love thee? Let me count the ways. I love thee like Howard Cosell doth love his blank.
Now that's an easy.
Have I broken your heart? How do I love thee?
Let me count the ways.
I love thee like Howard Cosell doth love his blank. It's up to you.
Hooray for the red, white, and blue.
Don't distract him. How do I love thee? Nothing. Are you ready, Charles? All right.
Let me count the ways.
Margaret? Jimmy said to Judy, how do I love thee? Let me count the ways. I love thee like Howard Cosell doth love his blank.
He's a disc jockey, isn't he?
Howard Cosell?
No.
You know how Howard Cosell is?
Yes.
He's the guy in the football, you know.
He's the guy that has the voice that I'd recognize anywhere.
Right. And he occasionally delivers an opinion, if you urge him a little. What do you...
Loves his sports.
Oh. Good luck, Margaret. She did very well in the first round, didn't she? Charles, she says, loves his sports. What do you say?
Annie, Brett, did you see that man come visit me just a little while ago? I said his big mouth.
Right.
It's 20 minutes in
So in the middle of round two, 5-1 the score, and it's going to stay that way for a moment or so while we do a little business with America. Here we go. Now, Missy, you have to match 4 to stay in the game, 5 to win, okay? Johnny, would you come over here, please?
Oh, sure. Oh, this is charming.
I want to tell you, not only is Johnny Olsen one of the world's greatest announcers...
Yes, sir.
This fella is just terrific. I've done shows with him and shows without him, and I gotta tell you, it's better with him because he's just marvelous. He's not only one of the world's greatest announcers, but he has been for over 2,000 years. As a matter of fact, Johnny hosted the world's first game show.
That's right.
Absolutely right. And the show opened. Where's the rest of it, fellas? You give me a two-part question? Would you give me two parts of the question? Where?
You must have it.
Oh, you've got it. Oh, you've got it.
I have a question.
So you've got the question.
But you've got to get ready for this, all right?
You ready for this?
The lead line up to there?
The show opened like this.
Live from Cairo, it's our favorite sweetheart, Cleopatra, starring in ancient Egypt's funniest game show, You Bet Your Blank.
All right, that's the question. Fill in the blank. I may have to ask you to repeat it one more time, so hang around here, John, would you please? All right, everybody ready? Charles, you finished.
That was wonderful, Johnny.
All right.
He's wonderful.
Now, would you do
wonderful.
Would you do it for Missy Gallant one more time, John? Stand up here with the light. I want everybody to see you there.
Just hold on a second.
Yeah. Oh, you're not finished.
It was misspelled.
Oh, all right.
Live from Cairo, it's our favorite sweetheart, Cleopatra, starring in ancient Egypt's funniest game show, You Bet Your Blank.
And a boy, John, thank you very much. Now. Ancient Egypt. Ancient Egypt, Cleopatra, You Bet Your Blank. It's easy for you. It's easy for me.
Mommy?
You bet your mummy. Well, that's ancient Egypt, isn't it? Okay. Now don't boo her. You'll make her feel insecure. No, that's not a bad answer. You bet your mummy is not bad. What have you got, Bobby?
You bet your asp is better.
You bet your asp. You don't watch this show very often, do you? Brett, what'd you say? You got to match everybody else to stay in the game.
You have to match everybody else to stay in the game?
Everybody to stay in the game. Everybody.
I feel terrible.
What? Brett doesn't play?
I want to say it anyway! Curtain off!
All right, Charles,
bet your ass!
What do you say, Charles?
Guard! I said ass.
Ass. Well, what the rest of you have? Well, here you are. You stand by for a moment or so. Well, Missy, you're going to leave us now, but you did win some money, and we had a lot of laughs. I hope you enjoyed it.
I do.
Good.
Goodbye,
Missy
Richard.
We'll be leaving with $350. Now, you come up here with me, Marty, and you've got your $100. Now you're going to try for over $5,000. Shall we begin?
Sure.
We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Blank. Joint. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500 if you match it, $250 for the middle, and $100 for the bottom one. Whom do you call on for an assist here?
Betty.
Clip joint.
Clip joint is one.
Betty.
Charles.
Hello, welcome to Good Morning America. Blank joint.
Blank joint.
This is all blank.
Do not kiss.
Bone joint. Well,
okay.
It's better than Twinkle Berry of last week.
Okay, so that's two. You got a one more to go.
Richard, please.
Present. What was the question?
The question is blank.
Blank
joint.
Well, first of all, of course, I would say bone joint, that being so popular. Has anyone said that?
Yes, yes.
I saw they might.
That's been taken.
Okay. Then I would say clip joint. Has anybody said that?
Yes, that's been taken too.
I hope they buzz me out very soon. Knee joint.
Knee joint.
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, I thought.
So you got knee joint, clip
keep
joint, and blow joint.
Keep the audience down, please.
And bone joint. You got bone joint, knee joint, and clip joint. You want one of those?
Being married to a policeman. I have heard of clip joints, so that's what I'll go with.
Right.
Very good choice.
I tell you frankly, I never heard of the other two.
You're really missing a big one with bone joint. No. I'd say that.
Bone joint would never make it. I am curious to see what I can't think of anything other than clip joint either. Quiet!
I'm sorry.
We all can't talk at the same time.
Yes,
pow! All right, we are looking for clip joint. Let's find out if it's under the $100 response. Knee joint.
I'm not surprised.
Right. All right, let's take a look at the $250 response. Clip joint, congratulations. What is it? Oh, you got a good luck charm there.
Chicken for dinner.
You had a piece of chicken for dinner?
And I saw this sticking out the side, and I thought, my gosh, I have a wishbone. I hope I have the good half. And I did, and so I've carried it with me.
Well, all right. You're going to be playing for $2,500, but I'm curious to see what's under the $500 response.
Elbow.
Beer joint. Very good.
That's the same thing as bone joint.
No, it isn't.
Yes, because when they finish the beer, they go their bone dry.
I see. Okay.
Keep it down in the studio.
Nice try, Charles. $2,500 is what you'll be playing for now. But to collect, you got to match one of them head-to-head exactly. Which one will it be?
Betty.
Okay, Betty, you get ready to write.
Let's try.
And Margaret will face me, if you would, please. And here we go for $2,500. Blank. Shorts. She's got it. Now, we want to know if you've got it. And are you on the same wavelength with Betty White there? What do you say to that? Blank shorts.
Boxer.
Boxer? Okay, Betty, may we see your answer, please? She says that'll match you.
Darling, I'm so sorry. I said jockey shorts.
Jockey! Jockey shorts.
It's been so long since I've, I get those all mixed up.
Is that the first thing you thought of?
No, well, there's two types.
There are two types, yeah.
Of those.
Jockey and boxer. Yeah. Did you think of jockey and rejected it?
No, I boxer came into my mind and I thought I should go with my first.
What does your husband wear?
It's always my very
Actually, he wears the jockeys, but I don't like them. I prefer the boxers. So.
Well,
Hogan, this cost you $2,500.
That's right. You could have bought a lot of jockey shorts for $2,500, I'll tell you that. Listen, Margaret, you got $350. You're going to meet another player in a moment, but right now we're going to meet this commercial. Now, let's welcome Don Great. Nice to meet you, Don.
Glad to meet you.
We're going to find out a little bit about you tomorrow, if that's all right with you, or
fine,
next show. But right now, let's start the game right now. Should we do that, Don? Would you make a selection, please?
Let's go with B.
B. Anything you say, Don, is okay with us. Everybody plays. Edna's cooking is so horrible.
How horrible is it?
Don't interrupt. That at the end of dinner, instead of giving you dessert, Edna hands you a blank. That's how horrible her cooking is. At the end of dinner, instead of giving you dessert, Edna hands you a blank.
Put something on the card, because that's the way the game is played.
Charles has not figured that out yet.
I see. All right. Okay.
Oh, that's cute, sweetheart.
All right. Just laid in there.
Thank you, Auntie Brett.
Miss Betty, honey, you're always so quick. That's good. Okay.
Smart.
Now, John.
Very tailored today.
Edna's cooking is so horrible that at the end of dinner, instead of giving you dessert, Edna hands you a
stomach pump.
Your creative powers are to be admired. But good luck with the answer. What do you say there?
I said Alka-Seltzer.
Alka-Seltzer. Brett. Good answer.
What are you doing?
I'm writing down stomach pump, because it's such a terrific... Oh, I can't use it.
No, you can't use it.
Oh, okay.
Nice
I
try,
feel
though.
Terrible. I said an airline's paper bag.
An airline's paper bag. Charles?
Ta-da!
Da-da-da-da-da!
John combed his hair, got all dressed up, looks very nice, has a suit and a lovely tie. Someone give him the correct answer.
Aha! With it. Sarah, what do you say?
I said Alka-Seltzer.
Alka-Seltzer seems to be the one. Richard?
Alka-Seltzer 2.
Alka-Seltzer 2. That's two glasses of Alka-Seltzer. What do you have?
I didn't say stomach pump, so let's just forget it, okay?
Okay.
Here's doggy bag.
Doggy bag. One for you. And your first round question is yet to come, but right now, friends, this is coming your way. Go. No, stop. That's the way it is. We've got to stop right here now, but we shall look forward to seeing your beautiful bodies again sometime in the near future. All right? Not yours, his. I'm only kidding. And your beautiful bodies.
Thank you.
Would you all bring them back sometime?
My beautiful body will be on Tattletales next week.
That's right.
Oh, I love it when you're strict.
Buddy, you're going to be on Tattletales.
Oh, don't leave
yes,
me.
Buddy.
All next week, right?
Say goodbye. Or
no,
tell
I'm not going to say
coming?
Goodbye. Who's on? Next time we get together, some of you will be here and some of you will not. These are the ones who will return.
Bill Daly, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Dr. Joyce Brothers, Richard Dawson, and Patty Doyle.
Keep living for Match 1075. Join us next time. Goodbye.
Fred Travellina, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Elaine Joyce, Dick Martin, and Debra Lee Scott as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game PM. And now, here's the star of Match Game PM, Gene Raver.
Now what happened, John? Oh, what a wonderful crowd you got here.
Beautiful.
Where'd you get them?
Prison.
Got them in from the farmer's market? That's terrific. Oh, we're going to have a good time, aren't we?
Indeed.
All right, let's start by introducing Alice Duff and Randy Aronson. Let's find out who you are and where you're from. Alice, we'll begin with you.
Okay, well, I'm from New York City.
Yeah. Yeah.
But I've been living here for 15 years. I work for a child care referral service. Yay. I have two beautiful daughters and a mother-in-law in the audience.
Right.
That's it. You want to know more?
Oh, wait a minute. That's two beautiful daughters, a mother-in-law.
In the audience.
In the audience.
Right.
Oh. But that's not it forever, is it?
Oh, no.
Okay, Alice. Good luck. Randy, how about you?
Well, right now I'm outrageously unemployed.
Uh-huh.
And I'm studying to be an actor by doing community theater, and I'm directing a show out at Pierce College.
All right. I point out to you that here on Match Game PM, you'll each have three chances to match as many of our stars as you can. And the one who's done that most often at the end of the third round will be the winner. Go on and play the Big Money Super Match, which can pay off over $20,000. Hallelujah. Here we go. Alice, A or B?
A, please.
Here we're off and running.
Okay.
Yeah.
Confucius say. Man who talk to blank should have head examined.
Man who talk to who?
Blank.
Oh, pardon me.
Diana Ross opens her new show in Vegas with our theme.
That's funny.
Even she's having trouble.
In case you don't understand what he's talking about, we're not too fond of the theme. Here it is. Confucius say, man who talk to blank should have head examined.
Well, she's going to hate me, but the only thing I could think of was Brett.
Her, Brett.
Well.
Oh, she's going to be an unhappy woman in about an hour and a half.
Don't let her have a clue as to what kind of car you're driving, because the tires will be slashed immediately. What did you say, Fred?
First of all, I think I should answer. It's a Chinese guy, right?
Yes.
Mention Richard Nixon as a Chinaman.
Richard
the
Nixon
Chinese
is a Chinaman.
Person.
Yeah. I never wanted to sell those tapes.
Okay, I said brick wall.
Brick wall.
No, man who talked to wife.
Uh-oh, you'll hear from the PRA.
You're going to get letters one way or another.
Uh-oh.
All right, Charles,
okay,
what do you say?
Okay,
you mustn't
imagine
talk
her worrying about someone's going to write to her when they're waiting to lynch her every time she turns the corner. Letters are 4 years ago. Man who talks to surf.
Seth.
South.
Of course. Now, wait a minute. That's good. That's a good one. Man who talks to himself should have head examined. Isn't that something?
Yeah. Thank you, Uncle.
I Go threw around. That out.
No, talking to yourself. You need help. Man who talked to himself should have head examined. What do you say?
Man who talked to his mother-in-law.
Yeah. His mother-in-law.
Should have.
All right.
Well,
man who
message.
Talks to a psychiatrist should have his head examined.
Very good.
Fitter.
Number one son, very smart today. Number one son come up with good answer. All right, lady.
Well, I figured there are better things to do than to talk to Dolly Parton, so... It's
right.
A different route. Now think about it,
yes,
okay?
There's some logic to that.
Would you want to sit and talk to the woman, or would you like to do something else, all right?
Down. Overtones.
From the hospital bed, Hank said, I'll tell you why I got all these bandages on my face. I got drunk and tried to kiss a blank.
run it back. There it is. Right in there.
From the hospital bed, Hank said, I'll tell you why I've got all these bandages on my face. I got drunk and tried to kiss a blank.
A lion.
A lion, huh?
No wonder he's unemployed.
That's it. Box yourself in.
A lion, he said.
I said that it was really fun because I really tried to do it. And it's all kinds of things. It's just awful. I had bandages about 6 weeks because I tried to kiss a porcupine.
A porcupine.
Why would those little devils think that was a good answer?
Well, because if you try to kiss a porcupine, you get needles and you get hurt all over your face.
Sure. You've heard of Needle Park? They used to have a swell time there.
No, that's something
else. Well, this is Needle Heaven. Porcupine.
Porcupine, all right.
A boring buzzsaw.
A buzzsaw. Well... Now, wait a minute. Some people are very fond of their buzzsaws.
Ooh, yes.
Yes.
And this guy was so fond of his, he tried to kiss it. And naturally, he got hurt because someone flipped the switch on at the time. I got these bandages on my face. I got drunk and tried to kiss a blank.
Trucker.
A trucker.
I like it.
Good, yes. Wonderful.
There are a few truckers that, you know.
Who wouldn't mind?
You never know.
That's right.
They're... I'm stuck with the old porcupine.
That's four of those so far.
Wow, that's great.
Four porcupines and one trucker.
I don't know. I mean, really, I guess I love jocks or something. I said a fullback for the Rams.
A fullback for the Rams. You got drunk and tried to kiss a fullback for the Rams.
They'd
All right,
it.
Hank.
Yeah.
Now, where are we here? Well, you're just getting warmed up. You'll get the hang of it a little later now. If you watch this, please.
We thought they right.
Here we go. Round two. Are you ready? Who goes first? You go first, because she went first last time. Turnabout is fair play.
I'll go with B again.
All right. Weird Willie is really weird. Today he wanted to go flying, so he taped 200 blanks to his arms.
Okay.
All right, here we go. Weird Willie is really weird, Randy. Today he wanted to go flying, so he taped 200 blanks to his arms.
Feathers.
Yeah! Feathers. Okay, feathers. Yes, sir? Feathers.
Well, now let me tell you something.
Yes.
Okay, I have come from a lot of weird little places. And I said that he taped 200 flies.
Flies. Took right off into space. Very good. All right.
Well, you know, I am an ardent admirer of the Grimm brothers.
You'll never get out of this one.
I am an ardent admirer of the Grimm brothers.
The Grimm brothers. They wrote children's books.
Yes. And so I said he taped 200 fairies. Right.
Peter Pan flew.
So did Wendy.
So yeah. Far, we've been on the air 6 minutes. We're going to get letters from Orientals, whites, blacks, and a few fairies in the valley.
Now, wait a minute. You know what's funny about that? There are no fairies in the valley.
I said birds, Gene.
Sparrows, yeah.
Uh-huh.
Okay. He wanted to go flying, Elaine, so he taped 200 Grimm blanks to his arms.
Feathers.
That's the idea.
Yes, we got it.
Bird feathers.
Two. Yes.
Feathers.
Well, that was an interesting round. We had feathers and fairies and all kinds of things like that. Now let's see what we have for you, Alice.
Okay.
He has three. You got a little catching up to do. At a funeral, you can always tell which one is the undertaker. He's the guy who's blanking.
Oh, I got it.
Alice, at a funeral, you can always tell which one is the undertaker. He's the guy who's blanking.
Smiling?
Smiling, she says. Good. I think she came up with a pretty good response.
What was her response?
Smiling is what she said.
Can I hear that again, please?
She said, smiling.
My name is Jimmy Carter.
Yes?
And I said, smiling too.
You did. Still not going to vote for you. All right.
I'm an anarchist. And yeah. I'm not going to vote for any of them.
I see.
But I did say smile.
All right. Peter Ellis.
Anarchist, please write us at box 216. Smiling.
That's three for Ellis, though. You can always tell which one is the undertaker. He's the one who's smiling, according to her.
Correct.
Oh, that's four in a row for her.
The only one
does it make money at a funeral? Smiling.
When you're smiling.
When you're smiling.
Oh, there it is. Just for her. Well, now, Randy, you can catch up and achieve a tie, but that's the best you can do. And to do that, you have a choice of A or B.
All right, one more time with B.
One more time with B. Here we go. Let's see if we get a tie.
You don't write down here.
You don't write
no,
down
it's
here.
Exceptional.
Only you up here. You're the only ones who do it. So I'll come up here so we don't have any misunderstandings.
Okay.
All right.
Kiss me on the neck.
Kiss you on the neck.
Oh, I can hardly wait to get to the ballot.
Wait a minute. You do Elmer Fudd, don't you?
Yeah, I do Elmer Fudd.
I'll do the introductory sentence, and then you pick it up in the quote there.
Okay.
Elmer Fudd said...
Friday is Bugs Bunny's birthday, so for his party, I'm preparing a bowl of his favorite drink, blank punch.
Did you understand? That's it. You didn't understand it,
huh? No, I didn't understand.
I did. Look at this.
Right.
Look at that.
That's it.
Have that.
Oh, yes.
Take it, babe. It's all yours.
Yes, why not?
All right.
Did you understand what he said?
Big Bugs Bunny fan.
Oh, you are? Oh, well, then you know all about Elmer Fudd. Friday is Bugs Bunny's birthday, so for his party, I'm preparing a bowl of his favorite drink, Boink Punch.
Carrot.
Carrot Punch. All right, Carrot Punch is what he said.
What's up, Doc? Carrot Punch.
Carrot Punch it is. Yeah. Boy, it's now 6-4. Two more to tie. Does he get it?
Just a minute, I take my retainer off. What's up, Doc? Carrot Punch.
Ah. Boy, it's now 6-5. One more and it's a tie game.
I'm sorry. I really am sorry.
Why?
I said carrot.
Carrot Punch.
Supposed to be a tiebreaker.
So we have to go to a tiebreaker. Oh, we'll do that right after we talk to America about this. Now, we don't have time to do our regular tiebreaker, so we're going to do a quickie tiebreaker here. We used to call it sudden death, but Charles objected to that, so we don't call it sudden death anymore. I have one question here. You will respond to that question, all right? And then I'll go over there and canvas our stars, and when you hear your answer, you will let me know. Write down your answer, then put it in this slot here. Here we go. Good luck to you. Blank ear. E-A-R. Blank ear. Blank ear, E-A-R.
Oh, I got it.
Now, here we go. Fred, you're up first. A verbal response is what I need from you.
Verbal response.
Yes. Blank ear. How do you fill in the blank?
I said deaf ear.
A deaf ear. Turn a deaf ear to that. Does anybody have deaf ear?
Nobody.
You no joking? Okay, one ear.
One ear. Who has that?
Nobody has
that. Oh, I have it.
Wait a minute. No, Charles is on his own. Let him do his own thing.
I'm so nervous. Is the camera on me?
Yes, the camera's on you. You're on. Good, nice, tight shot.
Makes you look old.
May the Lord forgive you for being that way. Yeah, yeah.
I've forgotten what we're doing, Charles.
I haven't.
What are you doing?
The show means more to me, Gene, than anything.
I know.
Blank ear.
Blank ear.
They're not going to get this one either.
Right.
Tin ear.
Tin ear. Who has a tin ear there?
What on earth did they say?
Well, I've seen both of their answers, and both of them have come up with wonderful answers.
Oh, okay.
Now, somebody here better say it, or you're all through. Hello.
Oh, boy. How about rabbit ear?
Rabbit ear is right up there. Let's see. There's rabbit ears, and he had an equally good answer, and he had cauliflower ears. Come on down, Alex.
Very good.
All right, you take your place on the blue dot, and for Randy, we have some prizes. We have a can of mildew and a black eye for Randy Aronson. Thank you very much. So long, Randy. Here you are. Now, this lady could win a real big bundle of money here. Over $20,000 could be hers. Let's see how she does now. She's going to do two audience matches. Let's begin with the first one. We polled the studio audience, said write down your best answer to this. Pumpkin blank. $500 for you for matching the most popular, $250 for the second most popular, and $100 for the third. Whom do you want to call on?
Brett.
Pumpkin pie.
There's one.
Elaine.
Elaine.
Pumpkin cedar.
Seeds.
Charles.
Pumpkin eater.
Pumpkin eater. All right, so you have pumpkin eater, pumpkin pie, and pumpkin seeds. Now you have the decision to make of choosing one of those or dreaming up one of your own.
I'm going to make amends with Brett and go with pumpkin pie.
All right. Let's see if we have pumpkin pie up there under the $100 response. Pumpkin patch. That's where pumpkins grow. Let's take a look at the next one, please. Pumpkin eater. All right. That's one that Charles gave you. Last chance for pumpkin pie. Slide the big one, if you please. There it is. Now, you've got $500, and that means at least you'll be playing four is 10 times that amount, or $5,000. However, you got one more audience match to go, and let's see how you do with this one. I did it blank.
Oh, all right.
Oh, my goodness, Fred.
Okay.
You
There's
say
only
it.
One way I can say this.
Go.
Go.
I did it my way. Very good.
Deborah Lee?
Huh.
Deborah
I love
Lee.
Frank Sinatra when he took my name. I did it on my own.
On my own, she said.
Dick? Well, I did, you know.
I did it before.
Lonely at the top.
And I can do it again.
All right. I did it before and I can do it again. I did it my way. I did it on my own. Those are the three. Now, again, you have to make a decision.
Well, I did it my way.
My way. Fred answer. All right. Let's see if we have I did it my way under the $100 response. I did it right.
Oh, it's the story of my life.
Let's take a look at the next one, please. I did it again.
I did it before.
All right, that was Dick's answer.
Here it comes.
Last chance for I did it my way. Here we go. Yes, sir. Another $500 means another $5,000. And that gives you a pot of $10,000 to shoot for. However, you're going to spin the wheel and you might transform it into $20,000. Step up there. Give it a spin. There's a peg. Grab that. And we'll all root for a double. Here we go. Nothing to it.
No.
It's only $20,000. Only $20,000 just means everything to her. The mortgage on the house and all of that, that's all it means. All right. Face maybe would please. Good luck to you. Here it is.
I want quiet. I'm nervous.
Here it is. Blank the hill. Blank the hill.
Takes much time. No,
all right. You're ready. You got
Stop
your answer. Now, you have to match her, and if you do, you get $20,000. What do you say?
Over the hill.
Over the hill. Okay, Deborah Lee, she says over the hill. What do you say?
Climb the hill, up the hill. I said over the hill.
$21,000 for this lady. Join us next week for Match Game PM. Gene Reberner, thank you all. Goodbye.
Some contestants will receive Eloquent Expressions from Samsonite, a collection of folding furniture and designer styles and colors. Eloquent Expressions from Samsonite, too beautiful to fold away. Dentine Chewing Gum. While you're chewing Dentine, it freshens your breath as effectively as even mouthwash. Brush your breath with Dentine. 20 Mule Power Industrial Strength Bathroom Cleaner. When your bathroom's a disaster, 20 Mule Power gives it the all clear. Search, the breath mint that gives you confidence of knowing your breath is clean. Search, available in snappy cinnamon flavor. STP's new Son of a Gun with Sunscreen, the only vinyl protector with exclusive sunscreen formula, shines brighter, protects longer, leaves a fresh scent. New Easy Caulker Aerosol Foam Caulk, no gun, no mess, outlasts four cartridges. Caulk it easy with Easy Caulker. And Turtle Wax, the world's largest selling liquid car wax that cleans, polishes, protects. And Turtle Wax Super Hard Shell Car Wax Kit cleans, waxes, and seals in the shine. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game PM, a Mark Goodson, Bill Totman production.